Hello everyone, Charlie here. Welcome to episode 2 of our hairstyle workflow series. In episode 1, we exported a full ZBrush hairstyle to 3ds Max using the export curves method at 100% previs, converted those curves into Ornatrix guides, and added quick clumping and frizz to test the look. Now that the curves are in place and ready, let's dive into lighting, materials, and real-time look dev to turn that raw groom into a polished, production-ready asset. In this episode, the second in our series, we'll take a ZBrush hairstyle, bring it into 3ds Max, and turn it into a polished, render-ready groom. What we'll cover? Preparing scene lighting and enabling key V-Ray Ornatrix options. Adding realistic HDRI illumination with a V-Ray dome light. Assigning the right V-Ray hair next material and fine-tuning presets, pushing the scene to Chaos Vantage for real-time look dev, tweaking depth of field, exposure, and vignette for a cinematic feel, smoothing strands with the Strand Detail Modifier, fixing bald spots in Ornatrix using edit guides, the comb brush, and the plant tool. By the end, you'll have a clean, natural-looking groom that matches across ZBrush, 3ds Max, and Chaos Vantage. Let's prepare the scene first. Enable the V-Ray Ornatrix modifier and turn on Generate W Chord. Switch on Dynamic Tessellation. Increase the Min Pixel Width parameter if strands look jagged. Now we'll add HDRI lighting. Create a V-Ray dome light and place it in the scene. Load an HDRI through V-Ray bitmap. Check the result in the viewport. It's time to assign the hair material. If a physical material is on the hair, replace it with V-Ray hair next. Pick a preset such as Ginger Red. Refresh the viewport by toggling it off and on. For a fast preview in Chaos Vantage, on the V-Ray toolbar, start Live Link or send the scene directly. Wait for the export. A fast GPU finishes in seconds. In Vantage, enable DLAA for smooth edges. The scene matches 3ds Max, but updates faster. Rotating the HDRI instantly refreshes the lighting. Let's refine materials a bit. Try presets like white fur, light brown, ginger red, scarlet red, aged dark brown, sandy blonde. Add depth of field. Set field of view to 20 degrees for a cinematic feel. Lower the aperture size for stronger blur. Enable physical camera exposure and fine-tune film speed. Add a subtle vignette if desired. Next, we'll smooth the hair. After edit guides, add a strand detail modifier. Set 70 points for both render and viewport. Turn on smoothing. Update the scene in Vantage. Strands become smooth. Let's tweak the skin material. Apply a diffuse color and an SSS layer. Note, Chaos Vantage ignores SSS, so the effect appears only in a V-Ray render. If you spot bald areas, here's a quick Ornatrix fix. Add an extra Edit Guides modifier above Hair from Guides. Temporarily hide heavy modifiers and switch to the default lights option. With Create Brush, draw missing strands. Small radius, count about 30. Isolate the area if needed, and use the comb brush with effects selected only. For precise placement, add another edit guides, and use the plant tool to interpolate new guides. Finally, let's verify the result. Send the scene back to Vantage. Bald spots are gone, volume looks better. An alternate workflow is to export only a quarter of the curves from ZBrush and finish the rest in Ornatrix. Same editing steps, just not shown here. Confirm that the final look matches ZBrush, 3ds Max, and Chaos Vantage. Thanks for watching. The journey continues in the next episode, so stay tuned. If you enjoyed this lesson, give it a like, share your thoughts or questions in the comments, and explore the other tutorials waiting for you in the on-screen preview. See you soon!